Hi and welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you this simple problem that we're going to solve using the Power Query. So as you can see, we have this blue colored table. That's our source data, and it includes a column of the label. So usually the content of the label are the column headings in a normal case, but in this case, it's going to be on the row. And then the second column is the data pertaining to the content of the label. And the desired output will be in the green colored table. So that will be the full name, and that includes a text combination that's coming from the different rows of our source data. So let me copy our source data here, copy that in another worksheet. Let's go to our worksheet here, and then let's load it in the Power Query. So in the data tab from table range, okay, so the first step is to group this table so that we can able to get the three rows, every three rows, because that's the pattern on our table. So in order for us to get the last name, the first name, and the middle initial, we're going to have the three rows, every three rows. So we need to create a helper column for that using the index column. So I'm going to add column for that and then index column from one. Let's do that. Okay, now that we get that, what we're going to do is to divide this index into three. So in this particular case, we're going to divide it into three and then use the number that round up. But if your example is combining text from four rows or five rows, that's going to be divided by five or divided by four. So it depends on the case. So in this case, we're going to divide by three. So let's add column again, custom column. And then let's rename it as the rounded index. And then in the rounded index, we're gonna use the index column divided by 3. And then use the number that round up. Okay. Number that round up. And then okay. That's it. So we have this grouping 1 and then 2. So while selecting this rounded index, this column, we're going to transform this. So in the transform tab, you can go to that and then choose the group by, and then let's rename it. Let's call it new table because the output is a table here. And then let's group it in all rows. Okay. So that's it. It's going to be our table, and that gets us with a three rows per table. So that's the last, first, and the middle initial. That's it. It's the same here in the second table. So we're gonna add another column that will have a list, and that will be able to us to get the data column. So I'm gonna add column for that, and then custom column again, and then let's call it the list because the output is a list, and we're gonna use List.Combine. And it requires a list of a list, so we're going to have curly bracket, and we're going to use the primary table, new table column, and then under that is the data column, so handwrite the data in square bracket, and then close the list that combine, and then OK. So that's it, we have a list here, and that would be the text that we're going to combine in one cell. So we're going to add the final column here to do that. Final column, so add column again, and then custom column, and let's call it the full name, and we're gonna use text.combine. We're gonna use the list column, and then comma, the delimiter will be in double quote, a comma, and then a space. So that's it. Now close it, and then I wanted to have the middle initial, a dot or a point after that, so we're gonna create that here using the ampersand. So we're going to use ampersand here, and then in double quote the dot, so that we can imitate that particular delimiter. So that's it, that's our output. We can remove the other columns, choose the three columns simultaneously, and then remove the columns. Okay, and that's it. Let's load that to the spreadsheet. Go to the home tab, and then close and load to. Let's use existing worksheet. Okay. So that's it. Now, let's quickly check it. For instance, we have some changes on our data. Let's say we have changes on the last name. Then when you click data tab and refresh all, that's going to be updated on the final output. And also, if you have another set of data, make sure that it has the same pattern, last name, first name, middle initial. That's it. Let's say it's the last, the first, and M. Okay, refresh all. And that's it. That's going to be added on the last row of your final output. And that's it. I'm pretty sure I'm done. If you like this video, you can subscribe in my channel. Click the subscribe button and see you next time. And thanks.